What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Season 2 of NHL 23 Edmonton Oilers Franchise Mode Series. Real quick, guys, I want to thank you so much for support on the first episode. 1,000 likes. Really appreciate it. If you wouldn't mind leaving a thumbs up on this one as well, it would mean a lot to me. Now, as you guys can see, we're currently 6-0 in the preseason. McDavid there has got 9 points in 6 games. If you guys missed that last episode, go check it out, because spoiler warning, did not win the Stanley Cup, unfortunately. Tampa Bay Lightning took that one home. We did make the playoffs, though. I believe we were a second-round exit. So hopefully, you know, we can build on that and go a bit deeper in the playoffs this year. I'll show you guys what our lines are looking like for year two. That first line there is so stacked. Draisaitl, McDavid, Hyman, plus 5 chems. So McDavid's supposed to be playing like 103 overall. We'll see if, you know, he puts up 103 overall stats. Last year, he was pretty, you know, mediocre in terms of McDavid's kind of standard. Second line there, even Nuge, Larkin we brought in. Huge free agent signing. Have like no cap room now. It's actually looking towards like, you know, next season. We're in a bit of a pickle, we'll say. Definitely have to move some bodies out next year. Evander Kane playing with them. So kind of all in on this season. Yeah, Modler on the third line with McLeod and Holloway. Fourth line there, actually like a lot. You got Nick Ritchie, Derek Ryan, Klim Kostin, like some big bodies there. Pretty decent defensively, definitely, you know, very strong physically. Defensively here, we traded for Chychrun, him on the top pair with Barry, Broberg, Nurse, second pair, Kulak, CC, bottom pair. And I actually asked you guys if I should, like, recreate the Ekholm trade. I think it literally happened a day after I recorded this video. And the top comment was Tyler here saying, I'm fine with you leaving the trade the way it is. So basically, we traded for Chychrun, and then I traded away Bouchard for Zachary Benson. So to trade Barry for Ekholm now would kind of leave us without a true offensive defenseman. So I'm glad that was the top comment. Stuart Skinner there, of course, our starting goalie. Looked really good last season. We got Anderson there backing him up. Hoping to get Stanley Cup for that 42-year-old vet. In terms of the power play, I mean, power play one looks absolutely unreal. Plus 5 chem. Power play two even, I think, is pretty solid. The four-man there, I mean, come on, McDavid, Draisaitl. I actually just saw McDavid broke Wayne Gretzky's record for most ever power play points in a season by an Edmonton Oiler, which is kind of insane to me. Not only because it shows how good McDavid is, but also shows how good Gretzky is, that, you know, he was setting those records, putting up all of his points at even strength. Like, if you asked me, I would have assumed a ton of his points came on the power play, but apparently not. PK1 there looks really good. Larkin McLeod quite speedy. PK2 is also solid there. Same with the third. I mean, we're just putting out the two best players. Barry there is pretty offensive. So, I mean, overall, I think it's positive chemistry everywhere, which is obviously a very good sign. AHL team this year is a lot better than last season. I hope they can actually, you know, make the playoffs. So we got Reed Schaefer there, who also, you know, should be traded away. But we did a different trade in this. Playing with the Wall there, Benson on the first line. You got Ty Ronning, Simoneau there, who I think actually just got a contract. James Neal, Martin Furk, Howden, Tulio. Someone said he's actually from Windsor, grew up in Windsor. I think his birthplace was Michigan, so if he wants me to keep on the team, I'll definitely do that. Ryan Reeves on the fourth line, I think that's a lot of fun. Jacob Millett here, Spitfire and fan of the channel. Also Jake Chase on there, not a bad prospect. So AHL forward group's looking good defensively. Not quite as good. We really have no good defensive prospects. So that's also something we definitely have to address. Rodriguez there starting with Hunter Jones. So two good young goalies in the AHL. Now, as I mentioned, guys, in terms of the contract situation, I'm looking at next year and, like, a lot of guys want raises. We don't have a lot of cap space. Like, right now we have $3.3 million. Barry's making $4 million. He wants $9 million. And we only have $8 million in extension dollars. And, like, he's not the only guy who needs a raise. You go down a bit. Philip Broberg here wants one. Luckily, though, I already looked. 2 years, $4 million. 1 year, $850K. So I'm going to give him the $850K for 1 year. I think, you know, we'll have to definitely pay him a lot the year after. But our window to win is right now. The cheaper we can keep good players like him, A3 overall defenseman, the better, essentially. So we'll do that. Yeah, Model's making $3 million. He wants $5 million. We'll probably have to qualify him. I think Holloway wants way too much, especially he's playing third line. I don't really see him producing too much. Goaltending-wise, luckily, Skinner's still under contract. Now, in terms of the captaincy, that, of course, has not changed. A lot of you did say you want me to trade Darnell Nurse. The coach is also the same, although if we don't win it this year, we don't play well enough. Definitely going to get a new one, because I'm not a huge fan of a defensive-style head coach, especially, you know, when McDavid and Draisaitl are on your team. I feel like you should be worried about all offense. Now, I'll show you guys our ratings here before we get started with the sim. Again, very strong team here. We've got 95 offense, 90 defense, 84 goaltending. So we get started with the sim. Again, we should be Stanley Cup contenders this year, so let's see what happens. And there we go, guys. Philip Broberg did accept that cheap one-year extension, so they'll help us out next season. And so it's down the end of December here, guys. We're playing decent, 2014-2 record. We're currently in a wild card spot there. We're also tied with the Kraken for third in the division. Win back of the Golden Knights, 2 wins back of the Flames. So, I mean, we're right there. I would like this team to be a bit more dominant, but obviously there are some holes. McDavid, though, going off kind of 48-36. Hopefully that continues. AHL-wise, Lavoie, almost a point per game, 23-27. I think it's, you know, pretty respectable by him. In terms of the standings, ooh, that's... I thought this AHL team was actually kind of nice, but I guess the defense is just not good enough because, yeah, we're 7th there. You got to be top 4 to make the playoffs. probably not happening, but hopefully at least, you know, our young players get some growth. Now, this is kind of funny, guys. I'm not saying yes to this trade, but apparently the Red Wings traded Ben Chiarot in that huge contract to the Senators. I wish I saw that trade. I don't think it happened at the deadline last year. I really wonder, like, did they pay to get rid of him? Because I feel like they would have had to. This is kind of funny, guys. The Montreal Canadiens are offering us Joel Edmondson in a fourth for 2/3. There were some rumors about Edmonton potentially getting him, but pretty sure he's injured for the rest of the season. Definitely saying no to this one, but wanted to share with you guys. All right, guys, so another deadline with a record of 33-24-7. Again, like, that's a good record, but I really thought this team would be more dominant. I mean, look at, yeah, we're second there in the division, 73 points. So luckily we do play in a weak division. Central's actually even worse, which is really surprising. But over in the East, Bruins 82, Panthers 80, Hurricanes, Penguins also in the 80s. But yeah, still can't complain, obviously, in a playoff spot. McDavid going off, 88 there and 64. He's actually 98 overall now, so I mean, he should be popping off like that. AHL team still 7th. Tyler Benson actually close to a point per game. And we might be calling on his name next year to replace one of the guys who lose due to the cap crunch. So we'll get to the deadline. I feel like, obviously, we're buyers. Like, we're trying to win a Stanley Cup for McDavid, his first one ever. But we gotta be smart here about the money we take back. Probably just looking at a rental. This is very surprising. Linus Ullmark, 8-9 overall there, 2 years left, $5 million. So I guess they're going with Swayman. John Klingberg still with the Ducks here. Pavelski. Kochkov there on the Hurricanes down 86. Kuzmenko, Fowler, Beauvillier, LeBanc, Bobrovsky. Matthias Ekholm there actually got traded to the Red Wings. He's on the block. 3 years left at 7.3. The Predators must have been under the salary cap max. I mean, I'd like to bring him in for the realism, but 7.3 million. There might be a way we can make this happen. What's his rating? He's 84 overall. He's actually gone down. Wow. So he must have not had a solid year last season. 8 points, 31 games to the Wings, 24 and 60. He starts at an 86. So he's already started to regress. I don't really want this guy. I'm not going to lie. Unfortunately, he just had a bad sim. And I'm curious to see how Skinner's been playing for us this season. Below 900 and a 3.26 goals against. So even in this game, goalies are so up and down. Because last season, he played really well for us. So that's unfortunate to see. Craig Anderson, though, actually putting up some pretty solid numbers. All right, guys, so right now trying to make a small trade to the Vancouver Canucks to get Tyler Myers on the block. And I'm first going to try this with them retaining 50%, but honestly, we can take back his full contract. Obviously, he's huge, 6'8 there, bouncer, total eclipse. So, I mean, he's good up front of the net, can screen the other goalie, you know, can push guys out of the way. I think he's a bit of an upgrade for us on Cody Ceci. You can see he's an 80 plus two. Ceci's making $3 million for the next 2 years, so I wouldn't mind trading his contract for next season, adding a Buffalo fourth. Value's pretty equal. I'm thinking I'll probably have to take out their attention, but we'll try this first. Trade's rejected, yeah. So we'll try taking this off, and if they then still say no, we'll probably add like a low-end prospect or another pick at that point. I really do think it should go through. So no retention. Trade's accepted. Okay, yeah, so there we go. Basically, it just means it's going to be harder for us to make a trade now because I want to see what do we have for cap space. Still have $2.5 million or so. Maybe could add like, you know, a fourth line forward upgrade. And I was taking a quick look at our defense, guys. Chychrun right now has only got 24 points, 64 games. I think I definitely have to increase his offense awareness a bit because like he's got really good puck skills and shooting. Tyson Berry though popping off, 57 points, 64 games, 25 minutes a night. It really sucks his contract's about to come to an end because he's going to want a huge raise that I don't think we're going to be able to afford. Also, look at this. Broberg's now 84 overall. So it's really good we got him extended when we did, even though it's only for 1 year. It would have cost us, I think, a lot more if we waited till the end of the season. All right, guys, so I'm trying to make one more trade here at the deadline, getting Jonathan Toews with Chicago Blackhawks. I signed him to 1 more year. I got my 50% retention, actually, because if we don't do this, the Blackhawks would be below the league minimum salary cap, which is kind of funny. I almost never see that. Obviously, a solid two-way center. I'm penciling him to our third line spot. I think McLeod either goes to the third line wing or the fourth line. Hardman is just there for the roster spot, and I actually only wanted to trade away Richie just because 1.75 for the next 3 years. He's physical, but I'm not really liking the minus 12 or like just kind of his game in general. The fact he's got 99 aggressiveness, that's a little bit too high for me. So I'm going to move on from the contract. Derek Ryan, I literally have to add because, again, we can't make the trade go through unless Chicago has enough money going back the other way. So that's why I have to send him over. It kind of sucks. AHL players didn't work, but we can call up somebody decent. Third round pick from Pittsburgh this year. Seventh round pick in a couple seasons. Hopefully they'll say yes. And they're saying yes, Tyler Benson's getting called up. Okay, so I think that trade definitely helps us out. Obviously, Toews on the PK. He's a veteran, which the game likes in the playoffs. So both those moves, you know, should make us more competitive, I think. And the trade line's now complete, guys. We'll see if there's any blockbusters that went down. Of course, our trade there for Toews. Matthias Ekholm goes to the Ducks. He's actually being kind of living out of a suitcase here in-game, which is pretty funny. Abramov goes back to the Maple Leafs. That's also funny. Our trade there for Myers. LeBanc to the Hurricanes. Beauvillier to the Flyers. Trouba to the Panthers, okay. Brock Faber to the Canucks for Jake Walman-Lazar. That's also a pretty decent trade, but definitely no blockbuster. Honestly, our trade for Toews might have been the biggest one. So after the trade deadline, guys, here's an updated look at the lines. Top six is staying the same. We've got Benson on the third line now, called up from the AHL, playing with Taze and Yamato. Fourth line there's Costin, McLeod, Holloway. So I feel like that's bottom six has improved, and again, we shed some salary for next year. Defensively here as well, Myers there on the bottom pair should help us out a bit more. Actually using Taze quite a bit. He's on the second power play. He's also playing on every single PK. Same with Myers too, so he's kind of in the same role as CeCe. I think he just does it a little bit better. And then in terms of the AHL team, obviously we lost Benson, but didn't look like the team was making the playoffs anyways. The fun strategy, I tried to sign a bunch of veterans like, you know, James Neal there, Martin Furk, Ryan Reeves. Didn't seem to work out too well, but that's okay. You know, we had to test some things out. So we'll spend the rest of the season here, guys. Hopefully, you know, picking up Myers and Taze help this team to continue to play well here towards the end of the season. All right, guys, so there's four games left in the season. I'm not liking what I'm seeing right now. We just lost our last five games straight, two to the Canucks, one to the Kings, one to the Blackhawks we took Taze from, one to the Wild. Luckily, still in a playoff spot, and actually not even a wild card spot because the West is that bad. The Ducks, there are 79 points, 79 games, have a wild card spot. I mean, look at the Central too. Then you go over to the East and you need 90 points to have a wild card spot. So kind of like real life, the East is a beast and the West is not the best. So we'll spend the last four games here. Hopefully can at least pick up a couple wins. There we go. So did not lose six straight. We actually finished with four straight wins and the Flames unfortunately take us out, but we'll have the Battle of Alberta there in round one, which will be fun to see. So 93 points on the year. Again, a decent year, but nothing crazy. Luckily still getting the playoffs, 42-31-9 record. McDavid here, 115 points. That's what you want to see. Ideally, he's putting up 150, but I'll take 115 from McJesus. AHL-wise, we finished 8th there, so we actually slipped a little bit. Lavoie, 58-71. Really nothing crazy. Zach Benson might be on our AHL team next year, which will definitely be a big boost if he doesn't actually make the NHL team. Draisaitl, 103. Hyman had a huge year, 79. Same with Barry, 78. Again, he's going to want such a big payday. I think we're just going to have to lose him, unfortunately. But hopefully, maybe get a couple picks at the deadline for signing rights. Larkin, 63 is not bad. Same with Nuge there. Kane, Taze had 50 points. How did he do with us, though? 11 points, 18 games. All right, I'll take that. Plus minus a zero. I mean, it's better than minus 29 with the Blackhawks. Yeah, Motto's 40 there. Definitely, yeah, after we lose Barry, Chychrun's 28 points is not good enough for, like, an offensive defenseman. So we're definitely going to have to make a few changes in the summer. Goaltending here, Skinner. Below 900, also, I don't like seeing that. But again, last year he had such good numbers, 912, 2.75. I don't understand what happened. Anderson there, actually, pretty solid. AHL-wise, our tandem, Rodriguez and Jones. Rodriguez not the best, but Jones pretty good, 928, 2.44. So maybe he'll be the starter next year. We'll trade away Rodriguez. In terms of the skaters after Lavoie, Tulio there, 48. Neal, 41. Three guys on the team with 40-plus points, that's it. That's rough. And in terms of the entire league here, guys, look at that, just like real life. McDavid won, Draisaitl too. So last year, Draisaitl won the Maurice Richard Trophy. He actually, I think, shared it with Pasternak. McDavid this year wins the Art Ross. Caulfield there in third, which is pretty crazy, with 99. Ovechkin, Suzuki. So I guess that was just a duo for the Montreal Canadiens. Keller there, I don't see any other Coyotes. That's insane, he put up 93 points with, like, no help. Kachuk as well, 91. Kopitar, big season. Matthew Kachuk. The Kachuk brothers went off. Goal-wise, Ovi there, 59. So he takes home Maurice Richard. That's all right. Take a look at defensive scoring here. Erik Karlsson, 85, leads the league. I mean, I'm liking what the roster's looking like. I mean, you got Karlsson there, you know, leading the league in points with a minus 13. Fox behind him. Barry in third. I really do think, you know, we could trade him for a lot. Even if he's a pending UFA, like, he had such a good season there. Goaltending stats, Shesterkin there and Anderson tied in wins. Best save percentage goes Spencer Knight, actually. 0.923. He's up to an 87 now. That's crazy. I started at 82, and that's kind of one of the reasons why a lot of times goalies like that will just have huge jumps. I mean, we saw Jonathan Quick last year, and then goals against here, Spencer Knight as well. So probably winning the Vezina Trophy. Rookie skaters, we didn't have one, but Shane Wright on the Seattle Kraken after going back to junior, 68 points. He actually outscored Connor Bedard unless Bedard went back to junior, which would be kind of insane for an 85 overall player. But I don't see him. Fantilli at 39 with the Blues. That's insane that Chicago sent Connor Bedard back to junior. I feel like that's openly tanking if that's what they did. Also, guys, I just noticed Montreal must have had Slokoski in the NHL last year. He's also considered a rookie, which is pretty funny. Same with Marco Rossi, another guy who's obviously playing in real life. In terms of the entire league here, guys, the Hurricanes won the President's Trophy. Looks like six of the top seven teams are from the East. Only Vegas there from the West. The Flames, though, had a pretty good season. We actually did finish 11th, not too bad. Columbus, that sucks. 12th of the entire league and you miss. And I mean, look at some of these West teams getting in. Winnipeg, Minnesota, Colorado there at 19, 87 points. Dallas, 22 with 84 points. Wow, yeah, just not even fair. And the Coyotes, they're last place in the NHL. So they're going to have the best chance to draft first overall. Speaking of first overall, I want to see, was Bedard back in junior? Because that's just insane if he was. Yeah, look at this, guys. Connor Bedard put up 81 points back in Regina. He's on pace for about the same as he had the year before there, 110. I can't believe the Blackhawks pulled that, 85 overall, and they're trying to be bad again. Like, Gary Bettman, go and check this out. There's some collusion going on. But anyway, guys, we'll get started now with the playoffs. Obviously, AHL teams not make it. We're more worried about the NHL team, though. And like I was mentioning, we've got the Battle of Alberta in round one. So we'll see what that Flames roster is looking like at this point. They got Mangiapane first line, Lindholm to Foley. They picked up Krejci there, and they're playing him on the right wing with Kadri in the middle, Huberdeau at the left wing, Coleman on the third line. He's 87 overall. That's nuts. I think he starts at like 82, 83, so crazy growth for him. Playing with Hallo there, Dubé. They got Ruzicka, Backlund, Pelche, fourth line. So a lot of depth there. Star player, of course, in Huberdeau. Defensively, they look solid. Weegar, Tanev, Anderson, Hanifin, Zadorov, Shillington. No holes there at all. Of course, Weegar, there's a solid number one defenseman. Goaltending-wise, they got Markstrom and Vladar still. So yeah, this Flames team's honestly pretty stacked. I feel like in real life, you know, they're definitely underperforming. On paper, they're a pretty good team too. So we'll see if we can take them out. I'm not really sure, honestly. Like, that team looks good. First two games here in Calgary. Let's see how we do. 2-1 loss, 2-1 loss. Both low-scoring games. Heading home to Edmonton now. 5-2 loss, 4-3 win. We hold off the sweep, but we have to win the next three straight here, not be out in round one. And again, this is kind of our year to win because, like I mentioned, we're going to be losing a lot of players this summer. Let's see what happens. We get a loss, unfortunately. Wow. So out in round one of the Flames, five games is all it took. Unfortunately, the Battle of Alberta did not end the way it did in real life. And just like that, we're out in round one, which honestly really sucks. And look at this, guys. The playoffs are complete. Carolina Hurricanes there win the Stanley Cup. Providence Bruins take on the Calder. And look at this. Anaheim drops from 10 to 1 to get the first overall pick, most likely taking Macklin Celebrini. St. Louis there stays 2, probably taking Cole Yzerman. Arizona at 3, they could get Kivaharju, who hopefully is like better in this draft because I did boost his rating. Plus, any prospects outside of 2023 will grow in the franchise. So let's see. Hyman there was over a point per game in the playoffs. Honestly, like, that Flames team just looked good. I think at that point, you know, just hoping for a good lucky sim, which we did not get. McDavid, Draisaitl were both point per game. Draisaitl, though, no goals. Nuge had 3. Larkin only 1. He's got to be better. Chychrun 1. Barry 1. Wow. Look at all these guys here not even putting up points. Nurse, Taze at 0. Yamamoto. Need to be better than that. Stats here for Skinner was actually not bad. 0.91 save percentage. Goals against 3.24. But, I mean, looked like he was under pressure there. A lot of shots against. Hurricanes were to the cup here. Let's see. They swept the Sabres. Beat the Penguins in 5. Bruins there went to best of 7. And Wild there, they also swept. So, I mean, obviously we got our work cut out for us. We got some moves to do this summer, but I'm still pretty optimistic. Let's see. Carolina, they're actually a clean sweep this year. I forgot they won the President's Trophy as well. McDavid, third Art Ross Trophy in the last 4 years. Also wins a Hart Trophy. Adam Fox there, James Norris. Cole Caulfield, Lady Bing. Shane Wright got the Calder, very cool. Terry Vinevall, people, Conn Smythe. And Shesterkin got the Vezina over Spencer Knight. I'm pretty sure they were tying save percentage goals again, so Shesterkin must have had more wins, as, yeah, Spencer Knight did have the William Jennings there. Larson, Bill Masterton. Shallow coach, Jack Adams. Interesting, you don't usually see a team win both of those. Lindholm there, Selke. McDavid also got 10 Lindsay, and then Ovi, of course, with that Marisha Shard. Quickly here, AHL, Calder Cup goes to Providence. Take a look at the individual. Leo Carlson there, most points. Brendan Brisson, MVP. Kunin, most goals. Carlson, best rookie. Granz, best defenseman. Schmid, best goalie. Steen, MVP of the playoffs. Carlson, sportsmanship. He kind of cleaned up, honestly. Carroll, there, community involvement. Hellberg, lowest goals against. I was hoping maybe we got, you know, some AHL award, but yeah, the team was not good enough. So, like I said, guys, definitely some moves to make here, but I'm excited to see some changes. Honestly, too, I think before I forget, people mentioned in the comments of the last video, I'm definitely going to do it. We need a new head coach, so I'm going to fire RIs here. Hopefully, I can find like a forward coach. I feel like, you know, Stahl's decent assistant coach. AHL team doesn't really have the best, you know, players, so I'm going to leave that staff for now. I'll look at retired players here, guys. Shea Weber retires, a member of the Arizona Coyotes. James Neal retired there, back with us, of course. Broussard, Seabrook, Soderberg, Ryan Ellis. I've actually lowered him to a 70 because looking like he might not play again, which really, really sucks. Other than that, really no big names. Take a look at goalies, though. Ben Bishop, another guy, LTIR, Kudobin there. So, yeah, really nothing too much in terms of retirement yet. So now, guys, we'll get to the draft here, and we'll see any top 10 picks on the block. The Devils there at number 8. Seems to always be number 8 for whatever reason. And wow, computer generated per Lilja, medium franchise potential. Honestly though, I hate when they do this. I guess, you know, Calabrini isn't in like the default EA roster, but I really wish, like, I have the prospecting draft class quality set to low, and that still happens. Eisman there is third, Kipharju fourth. Alexander Zetterberg as well, he's fifth. All those guys are real. You got Berkeley Catton there, Clark Caswell, Sam Dickinson, Tanner Howe. So pretty cool to see all those guys at the top of the draft, Henry Muse as well. Obviously, we're not going to be picking for a long time, if we even have our first round picks, which I don't remember if we do. Terry Thompson, here's a gem. Medium elite goalie, late second round pick, that's a steal. Kipharju at four doesn't really help us. Berkeley Catton at six also doesn't help us. This guy, I mean, that's like a third rounder. I guess I'll pin him. And I love my scouts, guys. Look at this. They have a couple of goalies here. We might not even get drafted. 50-50, medium elite. If we even hit on one of those, that's a steal. One's in Norway, one's in Poland. This guy here in Lithuania. Like, my scouts are going everywhere, I guess. And look at this, guys. I'm thinking maybe I could pull something off where we trade Nurse for Carlson. But look at his trade value there. Even at 34 years old, with that $11.5 million contract, it is still a ton. Which, I mean, coming off the season he just had, does make sense. All right, guys, now next year we're trying to trade the New Jersey Devils. As you can see, they actually have Sanin Palicka on the block. He's a guy I thought about drafting last year. He's like the only defenseman in the 2023 draft class supposed to go top 15. Right-handed offensive defenseman, high top four potential. Our first round pick this year is 20th overall. No way we get somebody as good as him. So it's like he's on the block. I feel like they might do this. Trades rejected. Okay, quite close value. Let's add like a 6th 2026. And there we go. Okay, so I like that trade. I'm actually still planning on moving Nurse here to clear up some cap space for this team. Hopefully, I can get back in the first round with the Nurse deal. And now next year, guys, are making a pretty bold move, trading Darnell Nurse to the Ottawa Senators for their first round pick, 24th overall. Nurse isn't a bad defenseman at all. He's 85 overall. The thing is, not producing for us. Like, he's got 17 points this year. He had 17 last year. Real life, he was putting up about double that. But he isn't playing on any power plays for us. Although I think he was power play too, but doesn't really get enough minutes, I guess. -9 there. And he's also got down in ratings. He did start as an 86. So just not really fitting on this team. And again, 85 overall, making $9 million. That's a lot. First round picks on the block. He's got about the same value as Nurse. And obviously in this sim, we got Chychrun instead of the office centers. So I guess Nurse can be like their consolation prize. Let's see what they say here. Trades accepted. All right. So that does clear up a ton of cap for us. Could potentially actually use it to keep Barry. We'll have to see. But I'm just going to sim to that pick now, guys, at number 24. And before we make our pick, I want to show you the top of this draft. I'm actually really liking how it turned out, aside from the made-up guy going one. You got Mathieu Calabrini there at two, who should have been one, of course. Eisman behind him, then Kipharju. I like the ratings, too. Like, these are guys you could put in NHL, but, you know, probably makes sense to keep them in the minors for a little bit, aside from, I guess, Calabrini and Eisman. Zetterberg there at five, Catton at six, Caswell seven, Howe there at eight, Massé there at nine, Dickinson 10, Muse there. So, yeah, definitely like to look at the top of the draft. Luke Misa there. Probably went a little high at 18 maybe, but that's all right. Cristoforo here is actually a Windsor Spitfire prospect, so that's pretty cool. I kind of wish I moved up three spots to the Buffalo Sabres pick now to get him, but that's all right. I actually have an idea for this next pick, who we're going to get, and that is Emil Vinny. Supposed to be the first goalie taken in the actual 2024 draft. Believe he's medium elite. If he's not, this is a bad pick for me, especially since I made the roster. And he is medium elite, yeah. 6'10 overall as well isn't bad at all for a goalie. You guys can see there, a few X factors. That's a pretty good spot to get him. And there's actually another goalie too, our scouts found. I'm hoping to get, like, end of the second round. And now next year, guys, we're going to trade Tyson Barry to the Rangers here to get their second round pick, as there's another medium league goalie I want. Thing is, after trading Nurse, I think we could actually keep Barry. And last year, he had 78 points. Like, a career year for him. Why get rid of him? I'm thinking instead, let's just trade a second rounder from next season, which, you know, might not even be that good, or I guess we'll have to do 2026. I'm only have a couple picks left in this year's draft. That is crazy. Like, we are losing picks so fast. Let's try 2027 fifth on top of that. They say yes. I think that was actually probably too much to give up because it was a late second. Thing is, like, there's a guy we know we want that's going to be good. So hopefully he's not gone. Doesn't look to be. Again, guaranteed meme league goalie here. Terry Thomas, American. 49 overall meme league. So he's a bit low rated there, but still not a bad pick at all in the second round. I'm trying to make another trade here, guys, with the Rangers, who up 14 spots in the fourth round. And I need a 7th D potential prospect. Wander here, 2169. Nothing too crazy. They say yes to that. Okay, that worked out well because not really a guy I probably would have been keeping. There's a guy that our scouts found that could be actually a bit of a steal here. The Volkov guy from Lithuania. Let's see what they have to say about him. 47 low elite. Okay, in the fourth round, that's actually really solid. And our next year, guys, in the fifth round. If you look at our pins here, you'll see everyone's going to go like really late. Like Schumacher there is going to go like not even get drafted. The other two maybe. So we're going to get a couple of late 7th round picks. We'll take Isaac Dembski here. and 48 medium backup. And now next year, you guys are making a way too complicated trade for 2 7th-round picks. Martin Bober taking back because I'm actually moving on from Rodriguez, who the Montreal Canadiens want, as I mentioned. Jones is going to be the AHL starter. Dembski there we just drafted. I'm just going to flip him. We're never going to sign him, so we can have a chance in Montreal. Matthews here, medium toxic potential, but he's already 25, only a 74, so he's going to be a bust. 7th-round pick a few years from now. Donato there also just taking back for the contract. He had the least values on the block. Hopefully this goes through. And it did. Okay. Again, that was like way too complicated for what it was, but I had to just kind of make something happen. Didn't want to give up, you know, more than we should have. We have the first pick in the 7th round. I didn't even realize that. Okay. So I'm going to go to our pins here. Again, we'll take, or not Schumacher, we'll take this Norwegian guy, Vetteral, 48 medium backup, another one. Are you kidding me? And our next pick here with Montreal Canadiens pick, we'll take Schumacher, probably medium leader, 50-50 chance, 53 overall, low bomb six. All right. So I did a bunch of trades there for nothing, but obviously you don't know until you take them. It's worth the risk for sure. Still came away from this draft with 2 million league goalies. Pretty happy with that. It's worth the resign phase here, guys. Almost $22 million in cap space. Obviously, that's thanks to trading away Nurse's contract. We also got rid of CeCe's contract and Nick Ricci's as well. So we have some space here to keep Tyson Barrie, who wants $10 million. I should have just traded him for a second or third round pick at the draft because last time he wanted 7, but he did just put up 78 points. That's sucks. Okay, so I'm not willing to give Tyson Barrie that much money. I actually do have a backup plan. I was thinking about doing it at the draft, but I decided to take a chance on Barrie first. Yamato here, third line winger, 3.2 million. I think that's pretty, you know, fair value, and looks to be around that for like the rest of his career. So let's try 4 years at like 3.3, see what he says to that first offer. Taze could bring back 3.5. We'll kind of see what the salary situation looks like. Dylan Holloway, 1.7. That's pretty fair. 3 years, 4 years. Wow, he could actually, if he turns into a player, this is an amazing deal. So let's do 2 years, 8 million. Pencil him on the left wing. Yamato's on the right wing. And I think Taze is probably on the center spot. Maybe McLeod. Tyler Myers, what's he want? 2.2. We could wait till free agency. There's really no reason we have to lock that in. Tyler Benson here is probably just a fourth liner for us, and he wants $2 million. So yeah, we'll qualify because it'll be like nothing, but it looks to be a bit expensive. Raphael Lavoie actually could be the third line center for us next year. Rock McLeod on the fourth line with Costa and potentially Benson. If not, we'll find a new fourth line forward. And now looking at our defense here, guys, the reason I want to pay Barrie is because we still need to sign one more defenseman to play with Chychrun, Broberg, Kulak. Assuming Niemelainen actually plays on the bottom pair, 26-79. Wants like no money. That's actually a great ask. I'm gonna give him extra money, hopefully 3 years there on entry level. Kesheling, 24-74, medium seventh. I mean, I guess we could do like a 1 year. Should be able to find better guys in free agency, but he's with the, you know, organization, so I'll keep him for now. Dvorak's now at 61, medium top four. I'd like to give him some AHL minutes, although it doesn't matter, just, you know, for fun. And then goaltending wise here, we did bring back Montembeau, who's 2 overall higher than Craig Anderson. Last year, 905, 308. Anderson at a 913. Like, Anderson's numbers were really good. Again, it would be cool to get the vet, you know, a Stanley Cup. Montembeau, like, he is higher rated, but, you know, just for fun, let's keep the 43-year-old. He's good for the room. He's like, you know, the team dad. 2-year deal? No, we're not doing that. We'll do a 1 year, especially at that price. $875K. Jones, AHL starter. Vinny, I'm going to sign him immediately. Be the backup in the AHL. Thomas there, you can see he's only 49 overall, so we'll send him back to the American program for a little bit. Anderson wants more money, even though I gave him exactly what he asked for. Feels he could impact an NHL roster more than being a backup. Okay, Dylan Holloway said yes to that long-term deal, so similar to McLeod, 8 years there, 2.2. Yamato said yes, what was it, 4 years, 3 million. Niemelainen, 3 years there, under $1 million. I think that's really good for a bomb pairing guy. Kesheling just in the AHL. Vinny, AHL backup. Dvorak, AHL defenseman. So we still have $18 million. Again, just Tyson Barrie for $10 million. I have a backup plan. That backup plan is John Klingberg. He's on the Ducks. Similar kind of style defenseman. He's making like $4.5 million. We do that, we still have like $13 million. To bring in a sixth defenseman plus potentially a star forward as well. Which is actually why I'm not going to re-sign Jonathan Toews here, guys. Like I said, I think we'll have the money. Can bring somebody else in. Obviously, I'm not sure who's going to be in the free agency, but we still could go after Toews if we want. And so Anderson here, I'm going to give 1 year, 925. If he says no after I let go of Montembeau, I'm actually going to be so annoyed. And there we go. He does say yes. He just wanted an extra 50K from us. And after that signing, both the NHL and AHL goalies are locked up, which is nice to see. And like I was saying, guys, I feel like Tyson Barrie's $10 million ask is just too much. So going to let him go. We could maybe bring him back, but I think, you know, the safe bet is just to wait till free agency and see what else is out there. Also, too, guys, I just noticed Draisaitl needs a new deal after this season, so we're going to need a lot of money for that as well. And the same goes for Jacob Chychrun. Both those guys are going to get at least, like, an extra $3 million each, so $6 million right there. And now, as I mentioned, guys, I wanted a new head coach. I feel like the defensive coach isn't the way to do it. So there's a few A-minus NHL head coaches. Obviously, ours is one. We then have a generalist and a forward. Eddie's here. He's got everything, including A-minus teaching coach influence. Bressois there, coach influence only a B. He's a generalist. So I think the forward guy is the way to go. He's got a better team fit as well. So Eddie, on modes turned off, I'm just going to outbid everybody here with like a 4.75 offer. And now, guys, we're taking a look at free agency. Obviously, have a lot of money spent here, $18 million. And look at that. Austin Matthews is available. Oh my God. I feel like people are going to hate this. 26 years old, a UFA, due to the Leafs contract. He wants to get paid. Would he come to Edmonton to join Connor McDavid, Leon Draisaitl? If we did this, we would have to trade away probably like Evander Kane or somebody just to, you know, free up a bit of cap space for the Draisaitl and Chychrun extensions. But Matthews is available. You have the money. How do you not go after him? Devin Toews there as well. I mentioned, like, you know, any superstar defenseman this team. He's an option too. Be $24 million between the two of them, which we don't quite have. Honestly, I feel like Matthews for us, kind of a waste. Like, we have McDavid and Draisaitl. Really, Toews is actually the guy I think would be perfect on this team. Top pair with Chychrun. I think, you know, you have to play the opposite side, but that is all right. He's 91 overall. Play good defense. Try 5 years. Oh, wow. He actually gets quite cheaper. The thing is, he's probably going to want to sign the $12 million deal because it pays him more. 36. He'd still be good, I think, at that point. 6 years, 12.5. This is a big-time offer. We'll try this. Again, we'll definitely have to trade away, like, Kane next season to free up money for Draisaitl's extension as well as Chychrun's. And I'm just looking at the other players available here, guys. Sometimes there's a steal. Looks like most of the asks are, you know, pretty reasonable. And I'm taking a look at goalie instead of curiosity. Are you kidding me? Wow. Connor Hellebuyck and Ilya Sorokin, both 92s, both available. That's pretty nuts. I got Fleury there as well. Take a look at two ways, because obviously our goalies are set. Even our, you know, AHL goalies are set, but if there's a medium lead available, you got to go for them. So no two-way goalies there. We actually do need a few AHL defensemen. Kaden Korschak, why is he a UFA? Vegas, what are you doing? He is 23, so like not that crazy, but I'm going to sign him. I'm not going to trade him back to Vegas. He's not like amazing. If it was like, you know, a really good prospect like Amirov was, than I would have. And as I mentioned, guys, we need a few more HL defensemen. Laxinen here, Oskari Laxinen, 24-78, medium top 60 potential. Is pretty good physical. Wouldn't mind adding him just to help out, you know, some of the younger guys. We'll do a 3 year, honestly. We'll do 825K. And I think after making offers on those two guys, probably wait a month or so. Hopefully some better guys become available. AHL team could also use some forwards, honestly. Probably like 3 or 4. So we're on Noel here, 23-74, medium top 6'5", really good physical. I could add him to like the bottom six, I think. Do like a 3 year, 850K deal. And this is surprising, guys. Protass is available. 23-79, medium top 9, 6'6". He's got total clips. I mean, he's pretty big as well. Like, we're just going to fill out the AHL team with a bunch of big players. And they're like, they're actually young too. 3 years, we'll do 900K. Just make our team a lot harder to play against. And in the same vein here, guys, Brett Leeson, 25-79, medium top 9, 6'5". I mean, we got to have a line of these guys. I think that would just be a lot of fun. Also, Liam Kirk here, I know, is a fan favorite. 24-77, medium top 9. I believe he's from, like, Britain. So let's do 3 years there until he's done growing. Hopefully he does well. And I just noticed, guys, look at how good Liam Kirk's shot is. I don't think I made it like that. So he must have just had a ton of good shot growth for whatever reason. 26 goals last year. Maybe that was it. Hepponiemi's an RFA. He's also got a good shot. That's what I'm looking at right now. Furyk, of course, a big slap shot. But he didn't really do much with it last season. Perlini, kind of the same thing. Alex Nylander, 26-78, low top 9. He did have 65 points last year. Could bring him in just to try and actually make the AHL playoffs this year. And I think this is the last AHL sign I'll make. Scott Reedy, 25-79, medium top 6. Another guy there with a pretty decent shot. 90 stick check as well. 90 strength. So probably could play anywhere in the lineup. And like I was saying, guys, my replacement plan for Tyson Barrie's John Klingberg here. I believe he's the same rating, but he's making less than half what Barrie was asking for. 4.3 there for the next 2 years. I had 62 points this season. You can see he's got the send it, take to tape X factor. Really good puck skills there. Good offensive awareness, good skater. He can run the top power play and play with McDavid Dreis, so I could see him absolutely popping off. I also noticed too, the Ducks' future decor. Are you kidding me? Zellweger, Drysdale, Mintikov, like not even fair. Now, the one thing that does suck, we have to go with a first round pick to get him, but if we keep making the playoffs, it's going to be a late first rounder. And I feel like a first round pick to save, you know, $5.5 million is actually worth it when you're a contending team, especially for two seasons. Let's see what the Ducks say to this. Trade's accepted. All right. So, you know, I think that's a good deal for us again as a contender. Hopefully, too, Tays says yes, as I feel like he's kind of the missing piece on this team. If we could run a top pair of him and Chychrun. AHL assistant coach said yes, waiting to hear back from the head coach still. That's the AHL head coach. For a second, I was worried. Hopefully, I can just offer a bit more money and get him signed. Are you kidding me? Dallas said no. Okay, we'll have to take the second option. Brett Leeson said yes. Noel, Korzchak there, Protus, Laxinen, Reedy, Kirk, Nylander, all the AHL players. And Devin Tays as well. Let's go. Okay, so that's a huge signing for us again. I feel like we don't really need Matthews. Tays though coming to this team. That's big. Now, we kind of got screwed here, guys, on the NHL head coach. I thought I offered him enough money. Apparently not. And there's only one head coach still available. He's got a B overall there with a veteran style. Team fit there, 46%, which isn't really the best. Looking to C coach influence. Coach influence is like the most important stat for head coach. I'm actually thinking just promote the associate here. He's a B-. B-, teaching, A- coach influence. We'll just hire like the best associate we can. I think that's what we have to do here, which really is annoying. I think this game relies a bit too heavily on like the coaches and stuff because it sometimes makes it realistic in other areas. I could actually get a defensive associate coach to make up for losing defensive head coach. I feel like this top one here, B overall, isn't bad at all. So offer him what he's asking for 1 year. And the AHL head coach who initially rejected me, you can see really good teaching, great coach influence as well. That's why I wanted him. So I'll just offer him even more money because I think he's worth it. And there we go, guys. The AHL head coach said yes. Hopefully bringing him in with all those players we signed, they can actually make the playoffs this season. Also, I was curious to see how much cap space we still have after trading for Klingberg and signing Tays. And we still have $3 million, which honestly isn't bad. Could sign like a forward. Really though, I don't think we need anybody. If anything, I'd rather save that money till the deadline. Because at the deadline, you can get them to retain like 50% of a $6 million player, which I think, you know, would go a longer way, bringing somebody in to kind of help out that third line forward group or whatever. I'm looking at everybody here. Really nobody amazing. I think I'd rather probably just give a young player some ice time. And now, as I mentioned, guys, I still need another AHL defenseman. I'm honestly looking at Delzato here, 34 years old. But all the guys that had potential weren't really great. So I'm going to bring a guy like Delzato who's higher rated, kind of does everything well, could put up points. Might as well do it again. Usually go for a younger player, but like there is nothing really here, which honestly is good to see because that's realistic. There really shouldn't be like, you know, any sick prospects available halfway through the summer in free agency. All right, guys, we're about to start next season. I saw Sean Durzi still doesn't have a contract with the LA Kings. They only have $2.5 million to spend, 25 years old, 83 overall. He's actually quite solid, I think, for us. He'd be a bit better than Nima Leinen. So I'm going to make an offer here. Bielek here, 1955, low top four, is nothing too special. So him in a second for Durzi. Trade's accepted. Okay, so we have the money to sign him. We're going to be in a tough cap situation come next year. But obviously, our main goal is winning a Stanley Cup now. So Sean Durzi, 1 year, wants 2.6. We've got 4.9 in space. 2 years, four. I feel like, is he still going to be an RFA in 1 year? He will be. Okay, so we might as well just do the cheaper deal because we still have control over him. If we can't keep him, we literally just trade him for picks. Also, too, guys, I'm curious to see Draisaitl, what he's asking for in terms of contract extension. 12.2 million. That's not honestly that bad for a 96. If he says yes to like an 11.5, for a 96 overall, that's actually a great, great price. There we go, guys. Durzi said yes to the 1 year deal. Waiting to hear back from Draisaitl. He said yes as well. Okay, I think, like I said, that's a steal. Also, too, Chychrun needs a new deal. 6.5 for one. Oh, he's actually asking for seven. 2 years, it goes up. I mean, I'd be willing to do, if he'll take the 1 year, 6.5. That would actually be not terrible. We could probably bring back like most of this team. Just run it back next season. And Chychrun did say yes to that. Okay, so the two, you know, biggest contracts I was worried about, we're good for at least the next 2 years. So basically next year and the year after, our best chances to win, I think. Also, too, guys, we still have to sign Tyler Benson here. I realized gave him a qualifying offer and he's holding out. He's actually cheaper on a 2 year than a 1 or a 3. So let's try 2 years at 850K. That way we don't have to worry about this next summer. And yeah, I think he's actually gonna pencil in our fourth line left wing spot this year. So hopefully he'll say yes. And I see John Klingberg's got 3 assists in 2 games in the preseason. And there we go. Benson did say yes. Okay, so Klingberg's got another point. I think, you know, he's bringing me a pretty good Barry placement. And now next year, guys, I'll show what this team is looking like heading into next season. Like I said, it's Stanley Cup or bust. This team is too good to be out in the first round again. So we got Draisaitl, McDavid, Hyman on that first line. Hyman's now an 88. Kane, Larkin, Nuge on the second line. The entire top six gets a +5. Like, come on. what team could compete with that? Even the third line there, it's a young gun line. You got Holloway, Lavoie, Yamamoto. Like, that's really solid. A couple speedsters there, Yamamoto, Holloway. Fourth line here, McLeod, Howden, Costin. Like, solid defensively, pretty physical. And then in terms of the defense, Taze, Chikrin, top pair is awesome. They get a plus five as well. Klingberg, Broberg on the second pair. It's a little Swedish duo. Again, Klingberg's like our new Barry. Kulak, Durzi, bottom pair. I feel like that's a solid, you know, bomb D pair. Durzi definitely, you know, relying on heavily now for the PK. Goaltending, Skinner starting, Anderson backing him up. Anderson has gone down by one, but still, you know, shouldn't be too bad. HL-wise here, Hunter Jones, the new starter. Vinny backing him up. In terms of that team's lines, I mean, we got Simoneau, Reedy here. It's actually an 81, but no spot for him in the NHL team. I feel like Lavoie should be the better player, so that's why he's third line center. But you can see, looks like he could be an AHL All-Star with, like, the puck skills there, shooting, even 91 stick checking, 91 strength. Playing with Tyler Benson as well, who ended up losing his spot on the fourth line in the NHL to Howden. Simply because Howden here, 85 D awareness, 87 shot block stick check. Compare that to, like, Benson's defensive stats, not quite as good. Second line there, Tulio now 79, playing with Liam Kirk, Alex Nylander. Third line there, Schaefer, Millett, Chiasson. Pretty young line there, getting a plus one. And then the fourth line here, this is the big boys. So you got Noel 6'5", Protas 6'6", Leeson 6'5". Like, they're just going to go out and dominate whenever we use them. Defensively here, Neem Lyons on the top pair, Laxton. Santa Palika there is on the second pair with Delzato. Kessel Ring on the bomb pair with Korschak. So, like, the AHL defense looks a lot better now. Just the AHL team in general, I think, should be a playoff team at this point. Like, we brought in a lot of better players. So, you know, hopefully they do well. In terms of the captaincy, we did lose Nurse, who was wearing an A. But I think it's pretty obvious who we get the other A to. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. I believe he is the longest-serving Edmonton Oiler at this point. So, that would make sense. Next year, guys, I'll show you the ratings for next year. Like I said, hopefully we can make a deep playoff run, contend for a cup. We've got 96 offense, 95 defense, 84 goaltending. I didn't even actually realize Tevin Tate is the third best player on this team now. So I feel like signing him is going to be huge for this team. Obviously, we'll find out in the next episode. So if you don't want to miss that one, guys, make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you enjoyed this video, leave that thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.